This is all of our charge, whether we have a fancy title or not, to actually care about ourselves and the next generation, to have people run for office who actually care more about the next generation than they do about the next election. Because guess what? When you are in Congress, the decisions that you make impact your state, they impact the nation, and in some cases, the decisions that are made in Congress impact the world. So I am running for this office to continue to stand up for the poor, the working poor, and the barely middle class. People from all walks of life, all identities who are struggling, who are catching hell. If we focus on Medicare for all, for example, increasing the minimum wage, for example, canceling student debt, survey after survey, poll after poll shows that the American people agree with us. I just don't understand how you could be against ensuring that people had health care. Hello, somebody. Wanting people to be able to unionize without fear of intimidation. How could you be against a movement that wants to ensure that everybody has clean air, clean water, clean food? How could you be against that? And what can be wrong with analyzing and understanding what the science says about what we as human beings have done to destroy Mother Earth, and how we have an opportunity to correct our wrongs and chart another course? Help us be a force for good and to get out the vote in this district, to vote for Nina Turner, the servant leader in this race. Because when it is all said and done, it's not just about Sister Turner. It's not about me. See, Sister Turner is a coalition builder. Hello, somebody. I am taking this movement with me, baby. Make no doubt about it. So in the Ohio 11th race, we are running a strong campaign and we are set up for success. But the ultimate poll is on election day, and the only people who can make that ultimate decision are the people who live in Ohio 11th. That is really what this is about. We are doing the countdown to August the 3rd, and we need your help in Ohio 11th. And when August the 3rd comes, victory is just right there, but we got to keep on pushing.